galloping swiftly, coats are glistening, rhythmic hoofbeats falling, listen. Tails are flashing, manes are tossed, plains are covered and rivers crossed. Two horses canter, stride for stride, fiery gleam on golden hide. They gallop, trot, whinny and neigh, capturing our imaginations and our hearts. Horses are said to have done more to change human history than any other domestic animal.
To my way of thinking, the horse is the most versatile of all the domestic animals. They are a symbol of speed, power, strength, beauty, agility, and intelligence. They come in a wide variety of sizes, shapes, and colours, ranging from the miniature ponies to the Clydesdales and Percherons. Think of all the beautiful colours we have, ranging from the beautiful Appaloosa to the magnificent Palomino, greys, bays, and blacks. And all the work horses do today, from pleasure riding and the thoroughbred racing industry, standard breds, as well as crowd control like the mounted police and riding for the disabled. Australia really was founded and grown with the help of the horse.
When leading a horse, always lead off the left side. This is called the near side, and most jobs are done from here. With your right hand, hold the lead rope close to his chin. With the left hand, hold the end of the lead rope so that it does not trail on the ground. Never wrap the lead rope around your hand or arm.
When tying a horse up, use baling twine, as this will break if the horse becomes spooked and pulls back. A quick release knot is an excellent way to tie up, as again, if the horse becomes frightened or caught, a quick pull will undo it. Before every ride, you should groom your horse. Removing the dirt from his coat will help eliminate itchy skin and saddle soreness, inking and feeling his best. Some grooming tools that are a must in any grooming kit is the dandy brush, the body brush, the rubber curry comb, the mane and tail brush, and the hoof pick. The dandy brush is used first. This loosens any dirt under the coat. Next follow with the body brush. This removes the loose hair and dirt that the dandy brush had just brought up. Always brush in the direction of the hair. While brushing the tail, make sure it is gentle so as not to pull any of the hair out. Use the hoof pick to remove dirt, sticks, and rocks from his hooves. There are different types of tack available, like the English saddle, the stock saddle, and the Western saddle. In this segment, we'll be showing how best to fit an English saddle and bridle. You should just be able to fit the width of your hand in front of your body without going off the edge, and the same at the back. You should just be able to slide the flat of your fingers under the saddle at the front. You should just be able to fit three fingers between the wither and the pommel, and the cantle and the backbone. Looking down the gullet, you must be able to see a tunnel of sunlight all the way through. The bridle should fit so you can easily slide a finger under it all over the horse's head. The brow bend should allow the headpiece to lie comfortably behind the horse's ears. You should be able to fit four fingers between the throat lash and the horse's jaw. The bit should be wide enough to avoid pinching. It should create a few wrinkles in the corner of his mouth. As with all athletes, warming up is an important part of exercise. This allows the horse's muscles to warm up and relax to avoid injury. First, we ask the horse to stretch his back and neck muscles by asking him to lower and stride out. Once this is achieved, we can ask more of the horse by bringing his hindquarters under him and riding him up on the bridle. Strenuous exercise can cause lactic acid to build up in the horse's body. This is commonly called tying up. To avoid this, it is important to work the horse down by allowing the horse to stretch his muscles and slowly lower his heart rate. After hard exercise, always hose the sweat off your horse. On colder days, a warm bucket of water and a sponge is more appropriate. It is important to make sure your horse is comfortable at all times. So this includes rugging your horse to keep him warm on cold or rainy nights. A light rug, also known as summer or cotton rug, is sufficient enough for a paddock horse during the day. This will keep the sun off their back without overheating them. On cold and rainy days, a winter rug will provide warmth and protection. In the summer months, a light, cool fly sheet and bug eye or fly mask helps protect your horse from flies and biting insects. Most horses are able to live off grass found in the paddock. But if your horse does not have access to grass, then you will have to supplement the diet. There are many different feeds out there for horses' every needs, including folds and dams, performance and pleasure horses. The main feeds that are available for horses are loosened chaff, loosened hay and cool pellets. A mixture of this feed twice a day is efficient. You don't need to keep your horse in a fancy stall with the best of everything. Horses are happiest in their natural environment where they are free to move around, graze and socialise. At the very least, a horse needs a pasture free from hazards with safe fencing such as wooden, plastic or vinyl rails or mesh wire fencing. Grass or hay for grazing, unlimited access to fresh, clean water and a shelter from wet and windy weather and shade in the summer. Not all horses need to be shod, but those regularly ridden on hard or rocky surfaces, or horses that compete, can be shod to protect their hooves from splitting and cracking. The horse's hoof is like our fingernails and constantly grows. The farrier or the blacksmith will have to replace the shoes every 6 to 8 weeks. Then the excess hoof can be trimmed and filed. Unlike shoeing, all horses need to be wormed to prevent intestinal parasites. Signs that a horse is infested with worms include poor and dull coat, signs of scratching on top of tail, and poor condition. There are many worming paste on the market and seasonal charts to help you know how and when to worm. Horses, like humans, need dentists. They should have regular checkups every 6 months till their baby teeth are replaced, then only every 12 months is required. Horses grind their food, which wears down their teeth and creates sharp edges, which can cut their inner cheek and cause serious pain. The dentist will use a gag and file these sharp edges down.